What is a leap year? Let's start with the basics and find out what exactly is a year. To a child, this may be defined as the time you must wait until the next birthday party. Maybe a better definition would be the time it takes the Earth to make one complete orbit around the Sun. A calendar year is made of 365 days. It's supposed to match the solar year, but things aren't quite that simple. It actually takes Earth 365 days, 5 hours, 48 minutes, and 46 seconds to complete its orbit. Those extra hours gradually add up so that after 4 years, the calendar is out of step by about 1 day. Every 4 years, an extra day is added to the calendar, making the length of the year 366 days. Easy, right? The problem is that because the solar year isn't exactly 365 days, even adding a leap day every 4 years means that the calendar is still out of step by 11 minutes and 14 seconds each year. I'm sure we could do something useful with these extra minutes. Over the course of 400 years, this would add up to 3 extra days. In order to solve this problem, it was decided to leave out the leap year 3 times every 400 years. So the new rule was, a century year would only be a leap year if it was evenly divisible by 400. This means that the year 2000 was a leap year, but 2100 will not be. So who figured all this out? The Egyptians were the first people to think of adding a leap day to the calendar every 4 years. Later, the Romans copied the idea. In 1582, Pope Gregory XIII reformed the Julian calendar, which was introduced by Julius Caesar in 45 BCE. By Pope Gregory's time, the calendar had drifted 14 days off track. He neatly solved this by lopping 10 days off the calendar, telling everyone that the day after October 4th was going to be October 15th. Bad luck for people with the birthdays during that time. The early Roman calendar, way before Julius Caesar's time, began the year with March. It consisted of 10 months, each lasting about 30 days, ending with December. They didn't seem to have counted the winter months. It is thought that 2 extra months, January and February, were added sometime around 715 to 673 BCE. This would have made February the end of the year, which might explain why a leap day was added to that month. Later, it was decided to start the year with January, as that month contained a festival dedicated to Janus, the god of gates.